He says if he wasn't playing on the tour, he'd be a weatherman. Stuart, how you doing?
I'm doing great. Thank you.
Good. First off, I believe it was 2007, I interviewed you, and you used the expression I'd never heard another player use to describe themselves. You said at that point in time that you felt like you had been an underachiever.
I've been close a few times and let a couple go, and I've been in contention enough where I feel like I could have won a little bit more. So that's why I'm just kind of honest when I say that I've underachieved a little bit.
It's hard to win on the PGA Tour. I mean, it's not something that you get out of bed and fall into. I mean, it takes hard work, and you have to beat generally 155 other guys.
When you set high standards for yourself and you work hard and you know you have goals that you really, really set yourself towards for every day of the year, then you expect those results.
How did the Stuart Sink and Twitter become synonymous on the PGA Tour? How did that all come about, and was it an accident?
There's a handful of guys out here on tour that have the charisma that sort of goes through the camera lens into the living rooms of the fans. You know, Tiger, Anthony Kim, Phil, you can pick them out. Most of us are more effective as golfers by being somewhat introverted on the golf course and keeping your emotions in check and staying sort of even keel. Translate that, boring. So I don't really feel like I'm a boring dude, and I really have struggled with that a little bit over the years, you know, feeling like the fans out there, I come across as boring to them. So I felt like Twitter would be a good way to get my personality out to the fans directly without having to worry about the camera. And I just started off one day. Actually, my kids helped me get started on it, of course, teenagers. They got me started, and I just started posting messages. And pretty soon, the surprise part of it is that people started flocking to my Twitter feed, and I just have a good time with it.
You get to spend a little bit more time at home than perhaps people realize. And when you're home, you are home. So you get to be full-time dad for a week or two at a time.
It's one of the best things about playing out here on the PGA Tour is that, you know, I'm busy, and I play around 25 to 28 weeks on the road a year. And when I'm gone, I'm gone. But the other half of the year when I'm at home, I'm a stay-at-home parent. You know, and I do lots of time-consuming work in the gym or practicing or whatever to get ready to be my best out here. But I try to do that when they're busy, either at school or just when they're busy, so I can be a stay-at-home parent when they're home.
Did you really want to be a weatherman?
I probably would be if I wasn't playing golf. Luckily, I have some skill on the golf course. But I think I'd probably be one of those weathermen that sits in front of the computer, not an on-screen guy.
Okay. Are you sure? I mean, we understand you've tried it.
I did try it. I got to go to the Weather Channel. That was a lot of fun, but it's way more challenging than I thought it would be to do that screen thing where you have your hands going and you're looking at different screens, you know, the blue screen or whatever. That is a tricky deal, and Paul Goodloe was there with me, one of the Weather Channel on-air guys. He was patient, but I think he was glad when I left.
So you wouldn't be one of those guys that sits out on the end of, that ties himself to the end of a pier when a hurricane's coming?
Oh, I could do that. No,
you
I could do that.
Like Jim Cantore?
Well, I'm about 225 pounds, so it'd take a big hurricane to blow me up.
We appreciate your time. Thanks,
Stuart.
That was great. It was really good stuff.
You got it.